Additionally, you can change the sort order for entities within the part. You can do a manual sort and select entities one by one in a desired order, or automatically through the auto sort option. There, you can select sorting direction and strategy, as well as if you'd like to sort smaller figures first or on a grid pattern. On the right, you can also select figures and move them backward, forward, and to the first and last position. The arrow buttons, dial, and simulate option will allow to move along the sorting order for visualization. You can also change the speed of the simulation visualization. The measure button at the right gives horizontal, vertical, and straight line length, as well as the angle between two selected points. It is also capable of measuring curve length. The array option allows to quickly copy entities into a custom-sized array. The array layout and direction can be modified. Distance sets figures apart between their edges. The offset setting will allow to set a distance between the center of figures. The dynamic array option will allow to build an array within a selected region with a specified row and column distance. The polar array will build circular arrays. You can specify an angle range in which the entities will be arranged, or an angle distance or offset between each entity. The amount of figures or graphics can be defined, as well as the radius and starting angle of the reference circle in which the array is being constructed. The clip command allows to chop an entity constrained by other entities. And the extend command extends an entity to the next constraining one. A very useful command is fly cut. It allows to continuously cut entities without resetting nozzle height or re-piercing, and by taking advantage of collinearity. It can be used on materials where a pierce is not necessary and can greatly reduce processing time. The circular fly cut option can cut circular grids or patterns faster. A maximum distance between circles can be set, as well as an option for sorting before the fly cut, keeping microjoins, identifying fuzzy circles in case the software is having trouble identifying circle entities from imported figures, and the safe fly cut option that reduces the travel speed a small amount. A racetrack fly cut can cut O-bound or rounded rectangles the same way as lines. This one in particular has a new threshold, scan length, which describes the horizontal distance between a common point on figures, while the max distance now describes the same length except vertically. A line fly cut can be selected. It will scan for collinear lines within an offset tolerance and a maximum length or distance. The fly cut will group these collinear entities or segments of entities and will cut all horizontal and vertical lines in one pass, reducing the cut path length. The coedge command allows to combine edges between entities to reduce processing and optimizing space utilization. Clicking the command and then dragging an entity to another will combine their nearest edge. Pressing Ctrl plus clicking and dragging an entity will copy it and attempt to coedge it again to the nearest edge. The group command can group multiple entities. Clicking on its dropdown allows to select all grouped entities, the group selected, the group all, and explode graphics. The bridge command helps connect two graphics, or split one graphic into two, by setting a width of material on the line specified. It will basically create line entities with an offset half the width from the selected line and constrained by the intersecting entities. It can be used, for example, to connect material inside a hole to its nearest outside contour. On the drawing screen, you can also export drawing files to the LXDS format and inspect the toolpath for crossover. Within the Optimize command group, you can find the Split command to break entities based on a point, a Smooth function to reduce the number of vertices on a polyline, the ability to remove duplicated entities within a tolerance or remove small entities based on a threshold, join splitted entities, segment and merge entities the same way as shown before, and the chop command that will break scrap material with a grid pattern for easier disposal. To the right, you can edit font and replace a shape with another entity from a list. The multi-plate command to the left allows to frame selected parts onto a rectangular sheet, sort of like a small nest. The max distance describes the length in which figures are grouped into one plate. If parts are set apart on a larger distance, two plate results will be generated. The plate's orientation and margins can be set. The batch import command on the dropdown will allow to add new figures from separate compatible files. To the right, you'll find the resulting plate or plates like a nest. You can rename the result, change the quantity and material, and also delete, select, and sort results, as well as export them to separate files. Towards the end of the taskbar, you can generate a processing report for the cut file with information about the part size, cut length, thumbnail, and processing times. Keep in mind the latter requires the correct layer cutting parameter to be selected for accurate processing information. The colors on the right describe different layer parameters. The same job can have, for example, a marking and cutting parameter for a metal type and thickness. Different parameters can be set to each one of the colors used on the drawing.